Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hajj may or may not be closed this year, but Allah Azza wa Jal's mercy is always open. Today, I'm going to talk about 10 activities that you can do with your young child that will help them learn about Hajj. But hey, if you don't know who I am, my name is Iman al-Hadri, a Muslim homeschooling mama living in the U.S. and blogging at Muslim Homeschoolers Unite, where we walk hand in hand with you on this beautiful journey we call homeschooling. So we all want our children to understand Hajj and the pillar of Hajj, but we don't want them to get overwhelmed with the manasik and all the details about the manasik of Hajj. So the best way would be through hands-on activities. And let's jump right into this activity or Hajj activity number one, plan and prepare for Hajj. Well, the best way to learn about it would be to go to Hajj, but let's face it, right now with the pandemic, that might not be the situation. May Allah remove it and open the way for it to be open. Azza wa Jal, ameen. But the better way would be to plan for it the way we do for any time, through making dua and financially planning for it and begging Allah Azza wa Jal. I haven't been, and may Allah open the way for all of us to be able to go with jami'al muslimin. Allahumma ameen. When your kids see you plan for it, they'll see that you prioritize it over all of your little beach vacations, right? So inshallah, may Allah open the doors to that. Hajj activity number two would be our Happy Hajj guide, which is almost done. You've been asking for it. We are so excited. Inshallah, and you've been asking for a Hajj guide that makes it simple and is ready for you, is developmentally appropriate for young children. And inshallah, it's almost ready. If you want more information about it, we'll have it linked down below in the blog post, which is linked in the description box, inshallah. And so you can pop your email in the box there and we'll send you more information. Hajj activity number three, talk to your child about your Hajj experience. Children learn through storytelling, okay? It's one of the oldest and most powerful forms of teaching. It offers a great way for children to enjoy stories. And when hearing stories, children learn to empathize with unfamiliar, you know, situations and places. So therefore, one of the best methods that children can learn about Hajj is to experience it through stories. Tell your child about your Hajj experience. And if you haven't been on, I haven't been on Hajj, you can adopt a Hajji. Okay, have a friend or family member talk about Hajj, inshallah. If your child is old enough, make sure they prepare some questions. And then afterwards, they can present it to the family, inshallah. We also have pictures here for you, a free download, Hajj pictures, and that will help you enhance your story, okay? Not that you need it, but it's fun. It's fun to have some pictures and the kids will really kind of memorize what you're talking about. So grab your freebie. It'll be on the blog post where it says Hajj picture cards and you'll pop your email in there. Hajj activity number four would be Islamic studies. It's not really an activity, but you can learn about it through the tafsir. And if you don't have tafsir books, we do have links to smartphone apps that you can download and learn about it. It's best to stay with authentic tafsir to make sure that it's not manipulated. So that's why we chose Tafsir Ibn Kathir. Hajj activity number five, read about Hajj in the Quran. We have listed some ayat here. I have listed the ayat here, and you can get on there, jump on there, and see all the different surahs and ayat that you can access those Hajj ayat. Hajj activity number six would be to read scholarly articles about Hajj. Obviously, if your child's older, they'll be able to conceptualize this. And so the articles that sum up Hajj virtues is really important, and we've included one. It's nice to hear Hajj stories, but to have something by a scholar is really important. Hajj activity number seven, one of our favorites, read Hajj-themed children's books. I'm going to just share a few today. I don't have time to always share all of the things, so I'm going to show you a few. This first one is one of our favorites, Going to Mecca by Sister Naima Roberts, who is a very talented writer and speaker. Mashallah, Allahumma barik. It is a lovely book. I'll show you a page of each book, I guess, so that we don't waste time. The next one is Tell Me About Hajj by Sunny Asnain Khan. This has facts in here, so it's a nonfiction book. Lots of details, so maybe you can't sit and just keep reading it to a younger child. You'll want to break it down into parts, but it's great that it has illustrations as well. So that'll be good for younger children. The third one is Yan's Hajj by Fawzia Ghalani. Now, I like this because it has like a farm theme in here and a farm animal theme along with Hajj. That's perfect for preschoolers and all young children for that matter. And the last one that I have for you today is NorKids Go to Hajj. Now, NorKids is a subscription. You'll receive a book that has two stories in it each month. To see if it's right for your family, you can request a free sample, which we have linked in the blog post below. I think if you buy the subscription, you might receive a new Hajj type one. I don't know. In Dhul Hijjah, I don't know. I'm not sure. This specific one is on Amazon, but it'll be very expensive. You might as well invest in the subscription, in my opinion. Hajj activity number 7 would be to conduct Hajj crafts. Now, you don't have to do crafts with kids, but they're fun, and kids do learn a lot from it. The books are enough, but Hajj crafts are fun. So, Hajj activity number 8 would get us then into our needle felted Kaaba craft. I do have a tutorial online. We're not done with ours because the needles broke, because these kids were just stabbing the thing, and that's what happens. And then they stab their finger too and start yelling, but they pretend sometimes like, oh, I'm all right. No, you're not. Those needles hurt. Make sure if you have a young child, they probably can't do it, okay? Unless you have a calm 5-year-old that knows it goes slow and you get those little gloves, okay? Hajj activity number 9 would be to build a Hajj puzzle. I don't really recommend this one. It's like little pieces, and my kids were on their own with this one, but then they were complaining. I can see why the directions aren't that clear. This was given to us by a family member. They purchased it from Eid party. And so, you know, it looks nice, but if you have a lot of patience and a lot of time, you can do it. Hajj activity number 10 would be to watch YouTube videos and documentaries on Hajj. You've got them on Amazon, on YouTube, people talking about their experience. Just watch them ahead of time to make sure that they're appropriate for children and that it's the correct information. And so, inshallah, if you benefited from this video, please smash that like button. Don't forget to follow our channel and hit that bell so you'll be notified of more videos like this. Thank you for spending your time with me, and don't forget to check the blog post in the description. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.